going on, Ja? Just with the roster, you've been working out with some of these guys. You already talked about Zach Edey, what you expect out of him. You've been this year six for you now. When you look at this entire roster, the makeup of it, the guys that they've put around, as Kleiman said, the core players, you, Dez, Jaren, how do you feel this Grizzlies roster this year stacks up with some of the previous rosters that you've had?
I honestly feel like this is, one of the best rosters, we had, on paper depth-wise, and, now being able to, see the guys, go out and, when we plan and stuff, gives me, even more confidence. I feel like we're pretty much loaded in every position, and it's going to be interesting to see, how it all pans out.
What's up, Ja?
What's up?
I know you're a gym rat. I know you miss being on the court. What are you going to take about getting back out there on a regular basis and competing back at the highest level?
You said what I'm going
to? Get out most, but getting back out there and playing on a regular basis.
It's, what I love to do. Obviously, it's my job. Obviously, I want to be out there every game. So now my main focus is to, be able to do that. So, recovery is pretty much been the biggest thing for me, obviously this offseason because of my shoulder and then ramping back up and, having to recover the other parts of my body. That's pretty much what I'm taking for. Obviously excited to be back out there on the floor and fight with the guys, but I'd rather play every game than, just half, so.
Taylor talked about kind of your joy being taken from you from not being playing basketball for so long. Is there a way you want to look back at the last year, maybe a year from now? Is there something you'll want to remember sort of about maybe the good or the bad that might have come from that?
Pretty much everything. Last 2 years, everything that I've experienced, everything that, I've been through, I want to, remember. That feeling I felt, each time, no matter, what situation it was. I felt like it helped me a lot, helped me grow more into a better job. Right now, I'm probably the happiest I feel like I've been in a while. Just having my family, my AAU team, and the little things I was doing to, keep me going, and that makes me happy. Being able to do it, this offseason, catching up with a lot of, my family, it's been good.
Mike Wallace. Ja, I know you had to learn to see the game in a different way from the sidelines last year because you couldn't play. I'm just curious, what did you learn about that process and even scouting some of your teammates to know how to better fit with them coming into this season?
Obviously it was a unique situation for us because it's not only, we had, a lot of guys out, which, we had to, put guys in, different roles and, just to see how well they played, obviously showed me that, they got a lot more in their bags, as we would say. So it's only right for me to continue to, make them play with, that confidence that they play like, each and every day, no matter, what it is. So being able to, sit out, obviously you said it was basically like a film study session for me to watch my teammates. I would say gave me, a lot of confidence going into this year on, how I can put them in, better places.
Ja, you talk about wanting to remember everything over the last couple of years. How much is that maybe motivation? The Nike commercial talked about, bouncing back and how you always do that. Is there a motivation to maybe remind the folks around the NBA that, you're still that guy and still able to be the player that you were before the last couple of years?
Honestly, I'm not even worry about, proving them wrong. Like I said, right now I'm happy and that's my main focus. I feel like a happy job is a scary job for a lot of people. So as long as I, stay happy and healthy, it'll be a great season.
Hey, Ja, how are you doing mentally?
I'm good.
The X because You talked about your mental health.
Yeah, I'm doing well. You know, I woke up this morning, as we all did. You know, we're blessed to be here, blessed to be in the position that I'm in, do what I love at, you know, the highest level, being able to take care of my family and also, you know, putting them in positions to, you know, in excel and whatever, you know, they want to do in life is my main goal. So all that's going well right now, so I have no complaints.
Hey, Ja, when you were out there with the shoulder injury, what was your rehab like, and what was going through your mind as far as, you know, how much you have to push it, and will it affect your play going forward this year?
Mentally, it was pretty much just how can I come back faster than, you know, the timetable they, you know, gave me, which I try to do, you know, every time. But with this injury, I had to actually be patient, and I feel like that allowed me to, you know, sit back and actually look at, you know, a lot of things in life that I feel that's important to me. So I had the opportunity to do that. So obviously I don't want to be in that position to, you know, have to go through rehab and recovery, but, you know, I feel like that helped me, you know, this offseason with my mindset.
Obviously, you only got to play 9 games last season. Marcus only got to play 20, but your time on the court did coincide with him being available too, so you got to play with him some. What did you get out of that period on the floor playing with Marcus and integrating with him, with Dez and Jaren, and what do you think about that sort of chemistry and how that'll work going into this season?
I look at Marcus as a, you know, important piece to, you know, this team, as well as the core guys that, you know, Coach and Zach keep mentioning. Obviously, he was Defensive Player of the Year. The games we played in, he showed, you know, what he can do for us offensively, whether it's, you know, shooting the ball or, you know, making plays for others. But I feel like he's our tone setter, him and Jaren, and, you know, being able to, you know, come into this season having both of those guys on the floor is our goal and, you know, something we're looking forward to.
All right, that's all the time we have. Thank you, John.
Y'all have a good day.